question for Kasper, or both of you, in fact. With both of you playing in England, you'll be very, very aware of the clamour for success for the England national team, and it's been so long for this country, and you'll be particularly aware of the phrase, it's coming home. Now, what would it mean to you guys to stop it coming home tomorrow night?
Has it ever been home? I don't know, have you ever won it?
1966 it was home.
Well, was that not the World Cup?
Yeah, exactly. But I'm saying, the whole thing about a national tournament finally coming home, finally the actual success this country craves. What would it mean to you to stop that coming home?
To be honest, I haven't given any thought to what it would mean to stop England more than what it would do for Denmark. I've focused very little on the England national team. It doesn't really mean anything to me. It's what it would do for our country back home. The joy it would bring for a country of only 5.5 million to be able to do something like that, or to compete with the nations that we're competing with. Not really a lot of thought to England's feelings in this.
Yeah, and we're back with our goalkeeper Kasper Schmeichel, Pierre and Pierre-Emile Højbjerg, midfielder, and we open straight away for questions. Patrick fra TV2 får lov at begynde. Patrick, værsgo.
Patrick from TV2, you're going to start.
For det. Jeg vil bare kort og godt høre jer begge to, hvad I især glæder jer allermest til ved i morgen.
We want to hear what you're excited most about tomorrow. I'm looking forward to the game.
Det er jo sådan nogle kampe, man drømmer om at spille, og
egentlig er
vintertiden bare det sværeste, så at komme ud på banen og komme i gang.
So the worst part is the waiting time. I can't wait to run out on the pitch and play.
Ja, for mig er det samme. Det der med, hvordan
it's the same for me.
Hvordan man sætter sig op til det hele, og hvordan man ligesom gør sig selv klar, og hvad det ellers
sidder uden for banen. Det har man ligesom styr på,
og få lov til at stå i sådan en kamp, og ja, også sådan en mulighed,
Playing this kind of game is a huge opportunity, so it's something that we're very excited
tak,
about.
Tak, Patrick. Steffen Kronemann fra BT er den næste i rækken. Værsgo, Steffen.
Steffen Kronemann, BT.
Ja, hej, Pierre og Kasper. Det her spørgsmål er til Kasper Schmeichel, først og fremmest. Hvordan tror
Kasper?
Du, Kasper, at den 8-10-årige Kasper Schmeichel, som boede i Manchester dengang, ville have reageret eller tænkt, hvis man havde sagt til ham, at han en dag ville stå i sådan en EM-semifinal fra Danmark og selvfølgelig til Wembley mod netop
would
England?
React if somebody told him that he would play
altså, det var jo altid en drengedrøm at blive fodboldspiller og spille for det danske landshold.
Så jeg havde nok troet på det. For the Danish national team. So I probably would
til,
believe
man jo, når man bliver ældre, at det er ikke lige så lige til at gøre.
You get to know as you get older.
Men at stå er jo fantastisk, og at stå med de her drenge.
But it's incredible to be here and to be with these
mange
boys.
År, den rejse, vi har været på.
We've been together for the past 10 years. The journey we've been on together. It's going to be a great moment.
Vi tager den næste i rækken er Alexander Thorup fra Jyllandsposten. Mm-hmm. Alexander, værsgo.
Alexander Thorup, is the next one?
Ja, hej, det her. Jeg vil gerne spørge ind til Harry Kane. Pierre, du spiller sammen med ham i Tottenham.
I want to ask about Harry Kane. Pierre, you play with him at Tottenham.
Hvad er han for en spiller, og har den givet de holdkammerater på det danske landshold nogle særlige råd i forhold til, hvordan man kan tilmænde spiller
and
for ham?
Have you og så vil given jeg gerne spørge Kasper Breivik til, about how
Harry Kane er jo den spiller
him.
I Premier League,
and Michael,
eller
Harry
du
er
den
målmand
i Premier League,
or,
som Harry Kane har scoret flest gange imod, det ved jeg ikke, om du ved.
You're the keeper Harry Kane has scored most goals against. What does that mean to you?
Er det mig, der starter? Jamen, Harry behøver jeg ikke at introducere for nogen som helst
i den her verden. I don't need to introduce Harry Kane for anyone.
Først og fremmest, bag lukkede døre, er han jo meget professionel. Han er meget vedvarende i det, han gør,
doors,
og det, han foretager sig.
He's very professional.
Så er han super dedikeret.
He's very dedicated.
Og så, når det kommer helt ned til det basale, så er han jo en rigtig, rigtig, rigtig dygtig fodboldspiller.
He's så, just an incredible football player.
Harry er for mig
me, Harry is
det ypperste. I hvert fald på hans position i den her verden.
The best player on that position.
En fornøjelse at spille med ham til hverdag.
So it's an honor to play with
him. Jeg er sikker på, at med de forsvarsspillere, vi har, så skal
sure
han nok få kamp til stregen.
And the
Altså, jeg kan ikke sige andet end hvad Pierre har sagt. Altså, han er en verdensklasse angriber.
I can't add anything. He is
en, som,
a world-class striker.
Garanterer der mål altid i løbet af en sæson.
Someone who can always guarantee you a lot of goals during the season.
En meget dedikeret, meget professionel spiller. En spiller, der er meget dygtig, ved hvor han skal stå. Meget instinktiv i hans afslutninger.
He's very instinctive.
Ja, altså, jeg vil da sige, han er nok i top 3, top 5 i verden af de bedste
afslutninger. Among top 3 or top 5 strikers
tak,
in the
Alexander.
World. Thanks, Alexander.
Og så til den næste, som vi bliver Bert Maldering from NOS, Dutch Television.
From NOS.
Yep. Hello, this is Bert Maldering from NOS Television. I think that at least 4 players of Denmark play in England who start tomorrow in the starting 11, and 2 of them are behind the table. Is that an advantage to play in England before such a game?
Well, I don't know how you know our starting lineup, but no, I don't think it's an advantage. Obviously, you know the players that you're coming up against, but I think with the way scouting and analysis is conducted these days, you know every player you come up against, in, no matter what country they're from. So. From my perspective, no, I don't really see if that changes anything, really.
Pierre, anything on that?
A little bit the same, you know. Again, I think European football is nowadays very very popular, very very known. But of course, the players that are in the England squad, some of us are facing them for years now, and week in, week out, and some of us are playing with them. But again, tomorrow is a particular situation, and everybody wants to bring out their A game. And yeah, will be an interesting game.